Well, hey everybody. Good morning. This is not the usual close-up. This is the recorded close-up that I'm doing. Even though it's the 27th right now, by the time this is published separately, it'll be the 28th. Of course, you can be watching it live right now, and that's fine too. Anyway, I just wanted to get a quick little close-up with each of the kittens and see their faces, and also Oshi here. And the nice thing about doing these pre-recorded close-ups is, of course, I can do them in parts, and the robotists will just put them together and upload them all as one thing. So I don't have to try to do 20, 30 minutes all at the same time. We can just weigh the kittens, and then I can record the next bit. But I wanted to make sure I started today with a recording where there's sound in the room, so you can hear me, I hope, because that's not always going to be the case, of course. So good morning. All right, let's go in some kind of order here. We got our cheat sheet. So now I remember the order. We'll just do Spyglass first. Spyglass, how you doing, buddy? Come here, pal. Hi, come with me. Hi, pal. Hi. Come on. Oh, he's so big. I know, he's so big. He weighs 10 ounces. 9.95, maybe. Let's have a look at your face up close, pal. Hi. You said it. So no eyes open yet, which we wouldn't expect. They're just a week old, so it doesn't make sense that their eyes would be open quite yet. But soon, maybe any day now. All right. So now Compass is all the way at the back, I think. This one's got to be Compass right back here. Hi, pal. Let's see if I'm right. There's a little Compass, probably. A little calmer. Compass is the small one in the family and weighs today 7.6 ounces, which is a good weight, but obviously much smaller than our big orange brother. Yeah. They're all boys, if you didn't know. All four of these kittens are boys this time. That happens sometimes. Next up is Caliper. So that last one was Compass. This one is Caliper. Yeah, someone said that the mnemonic that they're using is that Caliper has a big white stripe down his belly. He weighs 8.3. He has a big white stripe that you need calipers to measure the width of, which I guess is good enough to help me to remember which one is Caliper anyway. It's having some trouble. But now I've got it. So that's Caliper. Hi, Cal. Okay. And you can tell he's also the one with the white gloves on. Yes. Okay, hi, buddy. Hi, buddy. No, it's just a shadow. His eyes aren't open yet, but he's manipulating them. You can see when he's yelling, he's sort of squeezing his eyes a little bit, so it won't be long, I bet. Starting to figure things out. And then the fourth kitten is Astrolabe. Astrolabe went on a big walkabout last night. He was out walking around the room, looking at things, seeing how it was going. For like 20, 30 minutes, I guess, before maybe mom brought him back. I didn't watch the whole video, but TJ was describing it to me this morning as she was watching it. He weighs 8.6. Good job. And he's got all of his steps in for the day already, so you can just take it easy. Isn't that right? So I know it's hard to tell Astrolabe and Compass apart on the stream. It's hard to tell them apart in person unless you can see them next to each other. But we've got the fact that Astrolabe is darker with denser stripes, with darker feet, and also he's bigger. So that's what we're going on for now. Plus, he's still got his long umbilical cord. Astrolabe had one that was especially long left over, but that's going to fall off any minute now. So I wouldn't count on using that for much longer. They typically dry up and fall off after about a week. Well, hopefully that gave us a quick idea of everybody, and hopefully we'll get to see more of kittens up close as the day goes on. I'll definitely make it a point to get some close-up video of the older kittens today too, but it's more likely that that will be in a room that I don't have the sound on. So when we do it, you probably won't be able to hear anything. Of course, I am still working on all that. And someday the plan is for me to be able to get sound directly from the close-up camera, and then there can always be sound, if there's not something else going on that precludes it. But we're not there yet. All right. Well, hey everybody. Good morning. This is not the usual close-up. This is the recorded close-up I'm doing. Even though it's the 27th right now, by the time this is published separately, it'll be the 28th. Of course, you can be watching it live right now. That's fine too. Anyway, I just wanted to get a quick little close-up with each of the kittens and see their faces, and also Oshi here. And the nice thing about doing these pre-recorded close-ups is, of course, I can do them in parts, and the robotists will just put them together and upload them all as one thing, so I don't have to try to do 20, 30 minutes all at the same time. You can just weigh the kittens, and then, I can record the next bit. But I wanted to make sure I started today with a recording where there's sound in the room, so you can hear me, I hope, because that's not always going to be the case, of course. So good morning. All right, let's go in some kind of order here. We got our cheat sheet. So now I remember the order. We'll just do Spyglass first. Spyglass, how you doing, buddy? Come here, pal. Hi, come with me. Hi, pal. Hi. Come on. Oh, he's so big. I know, he's so big. He weighs 10 ounces. 9.95, maybe. Let's have a look at your face up close, pal. Hi. You said it. So no eyes open yet, which we wouldn't expect. They're just a week old, so it doesn't make sense that their eyes would be open quite yet. But soon, maybe any day now. All right, so now Compass is all the way at the back, I think. This one's got to be Compass right back here. Hi, pal. Let's see if I'm right. There's a little Compass, probably. A little calmer. Compass is the small one in the family and weighs today 7.6 ounces, which is a good weight, but obviously much smaller than our big orange brother. Yeah. They're all boys, if you didn't know. All four of these kittens are boys this time. That happens sometimes. Next up is Caliper. So that last one was Compass. This one is Caliper. Yeah, someone said that the mnemonic that they're using is that Caliper has a big white stripe down his belly. He weighs 8.3. He has a big white stripe that you need calipers to measure the width of, which I guess is good enough to help me to remember which one is Caliper anyway. It's having some trouble. Now I've got it. So that's Caliper. Hi, Cal. Okay. And you can tell he's also the one with the white gloves on. Yes. Okay, hi, buddy. No, it's just a shadow. His eyes aren't open yet, but he's manipulating them. You can see when he's yelling, he's sort of squeezing his eyes a little bit, so it won't be long, I bet. Starting to figure things out. And then the fourth kitten is Astrolabe. Astrolabe went on a big walkabout last night. He was out walking around the room, looking at things, seeing how it was going. For like 20, 30 minutes, I guess, before maybe mom brought him back. I didn't watch the whole video, but TJ was describing it to me this morning as she was watching it. He weighs 8.6. Good job. And he's got all of his steps in for the day already, so you can just take it easy. Isn't that right? So I know it's hard to tell Astrolabe and Compass apart on the stream. It's hard to tell them apart in person unless you can see them next to each other. But we've got the fact that Astrolabe is darker with denser stripes, with darker feet, and also he's bigger. So that's what we're going on for now. Plus, he's still got his long umbilical cord. Astrolabe had one that was especially long left over, but that's going to fall off any minute now. So I wouldn't count on using that for much longer. They typically dry up and fall off after about a week. Well, hopefully that gave us a quick idea of everybody, and hopefully we'll get to see more of kittens up close as the day goes on. I'll definitely make it a point to get some close-up video of the older kittens today, too, but it's more likely that will be in a room that I don't have the sound on. So when we do it, you probably won't be able to hear anything. course, I am still working on all that. Someday the plan is for me to be able to get sound directly from the close-up camera, and then there can always be sound, if there's not something else going on that precludes it. But we're not there yet. All right.